Welcome, my friends! In this video, we will discuss the confidence interval for the difference in proportions of two independent populations. By independent, I mean that the sample observations from the first population have no impact on the observations from the second population. Let's say we are interested in the proportion of adults living at or below the poverty line in a given city. We may have sample 1, which reveals that 0.2 or 20% of Grand Rapids adults are at or below the poverty line, and we might have a second sample that reveals that 0.14 or 14% of adults in Salt Lake City are at or below the poverty line. We assume these samples are independent, as they came from different cities, and should not affect each other in any way. The quantity we are trying to estimate is the difference of two population proportions, P1 minus P2, and the point estimate is the difference of the two sample proportions, p hat 1 minus p hat 2, which comes to 0.2 minus 0.14 and equals 0.06 or 6%. The interpretation of the point estimate is that we estimate that the number of adults in Grand Rapids that are below the poverty line is 6 percentage points higher than adults in Salt Lake City. An example confidence interval might be 0.02, 0.1, meaning that we are 6% confident that the difference in the proportion of adults in poverty between Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City is between 0.02 and 0.1. Notice that we can refer to proportions as either percentages or decimals. Both ways are acceptable. On a number line, the confidence interval would look something like this. The point estimate of p hat 1 minus p hat 2 is in the middle, which is 0.06. The lower bound is 0.02, and the upper bound is 0.1, and the margin of error is 0.04, the distance from the point estimate to either of the bounds of the confidence interval. At this point, I haven't shown you how to calculate the confidence interval, but we will look at how to do that very shortly. For two sample confidence intervals, there are three possible end results. If both values are positive, such as an interval ranging from 0.02 to 0.1, that means we are C% confident that the first population proportion is larger than the second population proportion. If both values are negative, such as negative 0.1 to negative 0.02, that means we are C% confident that the first population proportion is smaller than the second population proportion. If one value is positive and the other is negative, such as negative 0.1 to 0.02, we cannot conclude whether or not the first population proportion is larger or smaller than the second population proportion. Stopping to think about these rules, they should make logical sense. Take the first example. If the difference in sample proportions produces a confidence interval with two positive numbers, such as between 0.02 and 0.1, every single value in that interval is positive, suggesting P1 minus P2 is greater than 0 in all cases. The only way for P1 minus P2 to be positive is if P1 is greater than P2. Thus, the conclusion holds. The same kind of logic can be applied to the other two rules. Only when the number 0 is contained inside the interval, such as in case 3, can we not conclude whether or not the first proportion is greater or less than the second proportion. Thinking of our confidence intervals in this way is very similar to the results of a hypothesis test, which we will discuss in more detail in future videos. Here is the formula for the confidence interval for the difference in two population proportions. We have p hat 1 minus p hat 2 plus or minus z times the square root of p hat 1 times q hat 1 divided by n1 plus p hat 2 times q hat 2 divided by n2. Instead of using this formula, we will be using the TI-84 calculator. But this is the formula that the TI-84 calculator is using in order to find the confidence interval. In order to compute the two sample proportion confidence interval, there are two assumptions that must be met. You must have a simple random sample from each of the independent populations, as is the case for all confidence intervals we have looked at. Additionally, these four quantities must all be at least 5. This ensures that the distribution of p hat 1 minus p hat 2 will be approximately normal by the central limit theorem. This is required so that we can use the z-distribution when computing the confidence interval. Let's take a look at an example. Income data from 150 randomly selected adults in Grand Rapids and 200 adults in Salt Lake City revealed that 30 of the adults in Grand Rapids were at or below the poverty line, and 28 of the adults in Salt Lake City were at or below the poverty line. Construct a 90% confidence interval for the difference in the proportion of adults at or below the poverty line in Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City. We have two different samples, Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City. The sample size from Grand Rapids was 150, and the sample size from Salt Lake City was 200, which are our values for N1 and N2. The number of successes is represented by the number of individuals at or below the poverty line in each city, which is 30 in Grand Rapids and 28 in Salt Lake City, which are our values for X1 and X2. At this point, we are ready to head to the TI-84 calculator. In the calculator, press STAT, and then arrow to the right twice to get to tests. Arrow down until you get to 2PropZint. Press Enter. Now enter in the values we wrote down just a moment ago. X1 is 30, N1 is 150, X2 is 28, and N2 is 200. The confidence level, you may remember, was 90%, so we can enter 0.9. Arrow down and press Enter over Calculate to generate the confidence interval. The confidence interval ranges from negative 0.0072 to 0.12719. Let's draw the graph related to this confidence interval. Negative 0.0072 is on the left side, and 0.1272 is on the right side. The point estimate is the difference in sample proportions, 0.2 minus 0.14, which is equal to 0.06. The interpretation of the point estimate is that our best estimate is that the number of individuals in poverty in Grand Rapids is 6 percentage points higher than it is in Salt Lake City. Now we are ready to write our official conclusion. Our conclusion is that we are 90% confident that the interval between negative 0.0072 and 0.1272 contains the population proportion difference of individuals at or below the poverty line between Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City. We can also ask a follow-up question. Does our confidence interval suggest that there is a difference in the proportion of individuals at or below the poverty line in Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City? No. The confidence interval bounds contain one positive and one negative value. That means that 0 is contained inside the interval, and 0 represents no difference in the population proportions. It is important not to lose sight of what the calculator is calculating, since we are not actually doing any by-hand calculations. If the variable is the proportion of individuals at or below the poverty line, either in Grand Rapids or Salt Lake City, take a moment to pause the video and answer the following two questions. I'll be back in just a moment with the answers. Okay, the first question asks, what percent of individuals sampled in Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City are at or below the poverty line? Well, if we look at the output, we see that p hat 1 is 0.2 and p hat 2 is 0.14. Therefore, 20% of the individuals from the Grand Rapids sample are at or below the poverty line, and 14% of the individuals in Salt Lake City are at or below the poverty line. These could have been calculated from the information in the problem by simply taking x and dividing by n for each sample. Finally, what is our best estimate for the difference in the proportion of individuals at or below the poverty line in Grand Rapids and Salt Lake City? Well, you may remember that we did this earlier, but this number is really important, so I think it's a good idea to emphasize it. The point estimate for this confidence interval is the difference in sample proportions, 0.2 minus 0.14, which is equal to 0.06. We estimate that the number of people at or below the poverty line is 6 percentage points greater in Grand Rapids than it is in Salt Lake City. Alright my friends, we have finished our discussion of the two sample proportion confidence interval using the TI-84 calculator. We will be exploring many more fun and exciting statistical topics that you won't want to miss, so make sure to check out our other videos.